Hello students, welcome to the EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Richa Singh from Dairy Chemistry Department, ICAR, National Dairy Research Institute. Today, I am going to talk about supercritical fluid extraction, its principle and applications from paper Advances in Food Science and Technology. What is an extraction process? Extraction is a process that selectively dissolves one or more of the mixture components in an appropriate solvent. The solution of these dissolved compound is often referred as extract. It is therefore a solution process depends upon the mass transfer phenomenon. The factor controlling the rate of extraction is normally the rate of diffusion of the solute through the liquid boundary layer at the interface. Ideally, an extraction method should be rapid, then it should be simple and inexpensive in nature. It should give a quantitative recovery of analyte without loss or degradation. It should yield a solution of the analyte that is sufficiently concentrated to permit the final measurement without any further concentration. Also, one important requirement is that it should generate a very little or no laboratory wastes that have to be disposed of. The most common method of extraction of the sample is using a SOX-slate extractor with the help of different organic solvents. These organic solvents are hydrocarbons and chlorinated in nature. Then what is supercritical fluid extraction? It is similar to the SOX-slate extraction process, but here the solvent is supercritical fluid. The advantage of this supercritical fluid extraction is that it is a green technology, means it results in the waste material that can be easily recyclable and usable. So, in this module, our objective is to give you an introduction regarding supercritical fluid extraction to make you familiar with the common supercritical fluids and what are their common properties. Regarding instrumentation of supercritical fluid extraction, its advantages and application in the extraction process. Supercritical fluid extraction may be defined as separation and extraction of chemical compounds of interest from samples or products such as coffee, tea, herbs, and spices by using supercritical fluid as an extracting solvent or mobile phase. This technique resembles solvent extraction except the fact that the solvent used here is a supercritical fluid. The supercritical fluid state occurs when a fluid is above its critical temperature and critical pressure, that is, between the typical gas and liquid state, during which the solvating power of mobile phase will be at its peak. The first reported observation on the occurrence of supercritical phase was made by Barron in 1822. In 1970, a significant development in the field of supercritical fluid extraction occurred by decaffeination of green coffee with carbon dioxide as supercritical fluid. What are critical fluids? A supercritical fluid is any substance at a temperature and pressure above its critical point. It exhibits physicochemical properties that are intermediate between those of liquid and gases. These fluids can diffuse through solid like a gas and dissolve material like a liquid. Additionally, close to the critical point, small changes in pressure or temperature results in greater changes in density, allowing many properties of supercritical fluid to be fine-tuned. Thus, supercritical fluid can preferably substitute organic solvents for many of the industrial and laboratory processes. Phase diagram of supercritical fluid. The phase diagram of supercritical fluid describes critical temperature, critical pressure, and triple point. Critical temperature is the highest temperature at which a gas can be converted to a liquid by increase in pressure. Critical pressure, it is the highest pressure at which a liquid can be converted to a traditional gas by increase in temperature. Triple point, it is a point at which gas, liquid, and solid phases exist in equilibrium. Common supercritical fluid. Among the range of supercritical fluids used, water is used for power generation and carbon dioxide for decaffeination. Apart from the fact that carbon dioxide is environmentally friendly and generally recognized as safe by the Food and Drug Administration, FDA. It is widely used in pharmaceuticals, nutraceuticals, and food application. It is believed to be a good solvent because it is odorless, non-toxic, non-flammable, inexpensive, easy to remove from the product, and its critical temperature and pressure are relatively low. The critical temperature for carbon dioxide is 31.1 degrees centigrade and critical pressure is 72 bar. They are ultimately making it an important solvent in sample preparation of food and natural product. The ability of supercritical fluid extraction using carbon dioxide as mobile phase even allow the extraction of thermally labile, easily oxidizable compounds even at low temperatures and non-oxidant medium. Properties of supercritical fluids. Supercritical fluids have highly compressed gases that have both liquid-like and gas-like characteristics that make them unique for chemical separation. Following are the properties of supercritical fluid. First is density. Density characteristic of supercritical fluid is between that of a gas and a liquid, but closer to liquid. In the supercritical region, density increases with increased pressure at constant temperature. And when pressure is constant, density decreases with increase in temperature. The dissolving effect of supercritical fluid is dependent on the density value. Therefore, it is an essential parameter. Second property is diffusivity. Diffusivity of supercritical fluid can be 100 times more than that of a liquid and 1 by 1000 to 1 by 10,000 times less than that of a gas. Because supercritical fluids have more diffusivity than a liquid, it stands to the reason that a solute can show better diffusivity in a supercritical fluid than in liquid. Diffusivity is parallel with temperature and contrary with pressure. Increasing pressure affects supercritical fluid molecule to become closer and decrease diffusivity in the material. The third property is viscosity. Viscosity for supercritical fluid is almost the same as a gas. being approximately 1/10 of that a liquid. Thus, supercritical fluids are less resistant than liquid towards components flowing through. Critical properties for some components commonly used at supercritical fluids are: number one is the carbon dioxide that is very commonly used as a supercritical fluid. Its molecular weight 44, critical temperature in Kelvin is 304.1, critical pressure in megapascal 7.38, critical density gram per centimeter cube 0.469. The next most common used solvent is water, with critical temperature 647.096 Kelvin, critical pressure 22.064 and critical density 0.322. Other solvents used are methane, ethane, propane, methanol and ethanol. The following table shows the density, diffusivity and viscosity for typical liquids, gases and supercritical fluid. Compared to the gases, the supercritical fluids have higher density, higher viscosity and lower diffusivity. Compared to liquid, the supercritical fluid has density closer to liquid, viscosity lower than liquid, and then diffusivity is higher than liquid. The solvating power of supercritical fluids. The solvating power of supercritical fluids ultimately defines their limit of application, because the solubility of analyte typically increases with density and maximum rate of increase in solubility with pressure is generally observed near the critical pressure, where the rate of increase in density with pressure is greatest. Hence, there is often a linear relationship at constant temperature between solubility and fluid density for dilute solutions of non-volatile compounds up to the concentration where solute-solute interaction become important. At constant pressure, when solute volatility is extremely low and at density less than or near the critical density, increase in temperature will typically decrease the solubility. However, the solute entrainment in the fluid may increase at sufficiently high temperature, where solute vapor pressure also becomes significant. Under conditions of constant density, solubility generally increases with temperature. The polar solutes are the most soluble in the polar supercritical fluid, although nominally the non-polar fluids can be remarkable good solvent for many moderately polar compounds. The supercritical fluid have solvating power the similar to the liquid organic solvent, but advantages are they have higher diffusivity, lower viscosity and the lower surface tension, since the solvating power can be adjusted by the changing pressure and the temperature. The separation of analyte from supercritical fluid solvent is very fast and easy. Role of modifiers or co-solvents. In many cases, slow solute extraction kinetics or limiting analyte solubility in the fluid phase can be overcome by the addition of modifiers or co-solvents to the supercritical fluid phase. By adding modifiers to a supercritical fluid like methanol to carbon dioxide, the polarity can be changed for having more selective separation power. The co-solvent interacts strongly with the solute, significantly increases the solubility and enhances extraction efficiency. For example, addition of 1 to 10% of methanol or ethanol to carbon dioxide expands its extraction range to include more polar lipids and addition of 9% methanol increases the solubility of cholesterol by 100-fold. Instrumentation of supercritical fluid extraction. In the instrumentation, from a fluid source, commonly tanks of carbon dioxide, maybe other solvent also, and co-modifiers, both are mixed with sample and injected into extraction cell through syringe pump, having a pressure rating of at least 400 atmospheric pressure. The liquid is pumped to a heating zone where it is heated to supercritical condition. It then passes into the extraction vessel where it rapidly diffuses into the solid matrix and dissolves the material to be extracted. The dissolved material is swept from the extraction cell into a separator at lower pressure and the extracted material settles out. The carbon dioxide or other supercritical fluid can then be cooled, recompressed and recycled or discharged to atmosphere. Mode to run the instrument. There are two principal modes to run the instrument. The first is static extraction. In the static extraction, there are two distinct steps in the process. First, the mobile phase fills the extraction cell and interacts with the sample. And second, the second pump is open and the extracted substances are taken out at once. The second mode is the dynamic extraction. In dynamic extraction, the second pump sending the material out to the collection chamber is always open during the extraction process. Thus, the mobile phase reaches the extraction cell and extracts components in order to take them out consistently. Choice of mobile phase. In order to choose the mobile phase for supercritical fluid extraction, parameters taken into consideration include the polarity and solubility of the samples in the mobile phase. Carbon dioxide is the most common mobile phase for supercritical fluid extraction. It has a capability to dissolve nonpolar materials like alkanes. For semipolar compounds such as polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, aldehydes, esters, alcohol, carbon dioxide can be used as a single component mobile phase. However, for compounds which have polar characteristics, supercritical carbon dioxide must be modified by addition of polar solvents like methanol. These extra solvents can be introduced into the system through a separate injection pump. There are two main procedures to study with co-solvents or modifiers in supercritical fluid extraction. The first one is mixing of the modifier with the carbon dioxide flow, while the second mixes the modifier with raw material in the extraction cell. Next is the advantages of supercritical fluid extraction. The foremost advantage is the supercritical fluids are cheap, inert, and non-toxic in nature. a supercritical fluid can be separated from analyte by simply releasing the pressure, leaving almost no traces. Third, the supercritical solvents are chemically inert, harmless, and inexpensive. They can be released to the atmosphere without leaving any waste. This is the most important advantage of supercritical fluid extraction. Because of this advantage, the supercritical fluid extraction is considered as a green technology because it is environmentally friendly. The selectability of solvent in the supercritical fluid extraction is strength of solvent can be selected by changing the pressure as well as the temperature. Means if you want to increase the selectivity of solvent, you have to just change the temperature and the pressure. The supercritical fluid extraction is a very rapid process comparable to the normal extraction process. It completes in 10 to 60 minutes. Diffusivity are much faster compared to liquids, and therefore the extraction can occur faster. Next important advantage is there is no heating is required to get rid the extraction liquid. Thus, it is good for the temperature sensitive material. Because what we have seen in the conventional extraction process, that for removing the solvent, you have to heat the sample. If under vacuum you are heating, you have to go up to 60 degrees centigrade. So the conventional methods are not good for the temperature sensitive material. For those temperature sensitive material, this supercritical fluid extraction technique is very good because no heating is employed. And the next is the recovery of analyte becomes very simple if you are using the supercritical fluid extraction method. Applications of supercritical fluid extraction to food processing. The supercritical fluid extraction technology has advanced tremendously since its inception, and it is a method of choice in many food industries. Over the last two decades, it has been well accepted as a clean and environmentally friendly green processing technique, and in some cases an alternative to organic solvent based extraction of natural product. Important applications are as follows. The number one is separation of essential oils and its derivative for use in food, cosmetic and pharmaceutical industry. The supercritical fluid extraction has been proved in effective production of high quality essential oil compared to conventional hydro distillation. The second application is removal of fat from food. Supercritical fluid extraction is used for extraction of oil to produce fat-free and reduced fat potato chips and other snack food to satisfy the consumer need for lighter food. The third application is enrichment of vitamin E from natural sources. Supercritical fluid extraction is used in the separation of tocopherol and other antioxidant because they have greater solubility in carbon dioxide, and it also avoids the step of vacuum distillation, which usually result in the thermal degradation of product. The supercritical fluid extraction is also used for removal of alcohol from wine or beer. It is achieved by removing ethanol from water without removing the aroma compound. Next application is encapsulation of liquid. Microspheres or large capsules can be formed with the help of supercritical fluid extraction. It is also used for extraction and characterization of functional compound after coupling with HPLC for characterization of antimicrobial compounds as well as for food preservative. It is also used in extraction of carotenoids with minimum loss of activity. The next application of supercritical fluid extraction is in the area of food safety. It has been used in food pollutant analysis, mainly pesticide residue, pesticides, organochlorine, organophosphorus, organonitrogen, and pyrethroids, as well as for other environmental pollutants. It is also used in the rapid analysis of fat content from numerous products ranging from beef to oil seeds like soya bean, sunflower, safflower, cotton seed, etc., and from vegetable. In case of polar compounds which are not soluble in supercritical fluids, it could be used as an anti-solvent. Supercritical fluid main application is in the area of decaffeination. Alkaloids, organic compounds with bitter taste and toxic effects on animals as well as on humans, but they possess the therapeutic effects when applied in moderate doses are mainly found in many natural plants. Alkaloids such as caffeine, morphine, among other, are the active component in a variety of stimulants and medicinal product, and their recovery from natural plant is of great interest to the food, pharmaceutical and cosmetic industry. Supercritical carbon dioxide proved to be highly effective for caffeine extraction because of selected solvent and commercially used in decaffeination of coffee and black tea. Supercritical fluid extraction is also used in denicotinization of tobacco, means for production of tar-free tobacco. It is also important in chiral separation, that is a very important issue for pharmaceutical industry. The solvent and anti-solvent properties of supercritical fluid is also used in the recovery of alkaloid such as theophylline and theobromine. It is used for the microbial inactivation of foods, and its implementation as an innovative technique for the sterilization of thermally and pressure sensitive material is gaining popularity nowadays. Supercritical fluid extraction is used for reduction of cholesterol from dairy and food product because cholesterol is soluble in supercritical carbon dioxide and even more in supercritical ethane. The cholesterol high related to high blood cholesterol level in the blood is related to heart diseases and cancer. The next area of supercritical fluid extraction application is it has been proved effective for the production of high quality cocoa butter from cocoa bean. It is used in the production of particulate products like drug particles, drug containing polymeric particles, and solute containing liposome. Supercritical water oxidation is an environmentally attractive technology through which the organic material can be oxidized to carbon dioxide, water, and gaseous nitrogen It is one of the new potential applications of supercritical fluid technology. In addition to the homogenization of reaction mixture, the high oxygen concentration are attained in supercritical water. The application of supercritical water for the safe destruction of toxic material is a viable alternative to incineration and land disposal. Students, now we have come to the conclusion part of this module. So here we have seen that supercritical fluid extraction is a better technique compared to the conventional technique. It has because several advantages, and the most important advantages is that it can be employed for heat sensitive ingredient. Next is the choice of solvent in supercritical fluid extraction. We have seen that there are different solvent that can be used for the supercritical fluid extraction. But the carbon dioxide is the important one because its critical temperature and pressure is low, so it can be employed for the extraction of heat sensitive ingredient. Important advantage of supercritical fluid extraction was green technology, means it is very safe for the environment, and now there is a tendency to use the environment friendly solvents, so this technique is a replacement of conventional technique. The next advantage was that it was the safe destruction method for the toxic material, and it can be used as a viable alternative for the incineration and as well as for the land disposal. Thank you.